This course will focus on solutions where the solvent is a liquid, and in particular, we will focus on aqueous solutions where the solvent is water. Solutions also exist in the solid and gas phases, with our atmosphere being the best example of a gaseous solution of nitrogen, oxygen, argon, water vapor, carbon dioxide, and other trace gases. In an aqueous solution, we have two types of solutes, non-electrolytes and electrolytes. When dissolved in water, non-electrolytes remain intact, while electrolytes dissociate into ions. For example, sugar molecules in water remain sugar molecules. Meanwhile, table salt dissociates into sodium cations and chloride anions. Sugar is thus a non-electrolyte, and table salt is an electrolyte. Electrolytes dissociate into ions. When two solutions of different electrolytes are mixed, the cations of one solution may have strong interactions with the anions of the other. Their attraction is so strong that they combine to form a solid, which we call a precipitate. We can determine whether or not a precipitate will be formed by knowing a simple set of solubility rules. If an ionic solid is insoluble, then a precipitate will form. When writing the precipitation reaction, we can use the molecular equation, but it ignores the fact that the molecules in question actually dissociate into ions when placed in water. If we account for this, we have the ionic equation. Though more accurate in representing what is really occurring, we note that some ions simply do nothing and appear as both reactant and product. We call these spectator ions. If we eliminate the spectator ions, we finish with the net ionic equation, the simplest way of representing the precipitation reaction that may occur when two solutions of different electrolytes are mixed together. Another type of reaction is what we call an acid-base reaction. In this course, we will use Bronsted-Lowry's definition of acids and bases. Acids give protons, and bases accept them. An acid cannot be an acid unless a base is present. Though we may often indicate a proton as existing in water, in reality they form a distinct H3O plus molecule. So when we have an acid in water, the acid liberates the proton, but the water plays the role of a base as it accepts the proton to form H3O plus. Acids can be monoprotic and release a single proton, or it can be multiprotic and release two or more protons. Be careful, do not equate the number of protons with the strength of an acid. They are unrelated. As we shall see later in this course, nitric acid is a strong monoprotic acid, while phosphoric acid is a weak triprotic acid. Finally, some molecules can be both acid and base. We call them amphoteric. Water is amphoteric, as it can give a proton to become the OH- anion, or accept the proton to become the H3O+ cation. The bicarbonate ion found in simple baking soda is also an amphoteric species.